everyone, my name is Katherine and this is Double O Kidney. Welcome to our journey together to a better kidney health. In this video, I'll show you three powerful ways to fight and reduce inflammation in your body and to repair the damage it causes to your kidneys. It's very common for people with kidney disease to suffer from inflammation, which can cause joint pain, fatigue, and unfortunately, it can also lead to cardiovascular disease, a faster progression to end-stage renal disease, and even an increased rate of death. Now, some good news. With the right diet and home remedies, you can solve this problem and give your kidneys the best chance to recover. To do this, we need first to know our enemy a little bit better. So, question: what is inflammation? Inflammation is the immune response by the body to heal himself from injuries and from foreign invasion. Think of inflammation as the body's natural response to protect itself against harm. This happens to everyone. If you bang your knee, if you cut your finger, or even if you have a cold, your immune system dispatches an army of white blood cells to surround and protect the area, creating visible redness and swelling. It's a necessary and beneficial process the body used to heal itself. But it's only beneficial to the body until it starts to attack its own cells. Let's understand when inflammation is not beneficial. There are two types of inflammation, acute and chronic. The acute type occurs when you bang your knee or cut your finger. Acute means that it's only temporary. It's a healing process. When the wound has healed, inflammation will disappear. But there is also a dangerous type of inflammation. It's chronic inflammation. Chronic means that inflammation is always present even when there's no need. If inflammation occurs when there is nothing to fight or fend off, inflammation turns on the body and can lead to diseases such as rheumatoid arthritis, hay fever, and atherosclerosis, to name a few. According to several studies, chronic inflammation is not just very common in CKD. It can even damage your kidneys and make kidney disease progress faster. This happens because inflammation can restrict the blood flow to the kidneys, damaging them, and also cause hypertension. Also, it may cause heart attacks, especially if there is plaque in the arteries. Inflammation is so dangerous that the most commonly prescribed heart medications, statins, are mostly used to fight the dangers it can cause. Now you may ask, how do you know if you have an ongoing chronic inflammation? Symptoms such as muscle or joint pain, constant chronic fatigue and insomnia, mood disorders, weight gain, digestive issues, but also high blood pressure may be signs of inflammation. These symptoms can range from mild to severe and last for several months or years. And there's a test that can be done to know if there's inflammation going on in the body. A simple blood test called the hsCRP test can measure C-reactive protein or CRP, which is a marker for inflammation. But many doctors don't routinely recommend the hsCRP test. They rely most on symptoms. Now, as you may have noticed, these symptoms are very common and very frequent in people with kidney disease. But why is chronic inflammation so common in CKD? Inflammation in people who have CKD can have several causes, including anemia, a very frequent complication, even of the early stages of CKD, and uremia, extra waste in the blood, another complication. Also, poor nutrition. This is very important. I'll show you how to solve this in a moment. And also, dialysis, vascular access infection, and gum disease, or poor dental health. These conditions are very common and each one of them can cause inflammation. But there are also other causes that affect people with or without CKD. Infections that linger, toxins, pollutants, insomnia, lack of exercise, obesity. So, this slide should already give us some directions on how to treat and prevent inflammation. It's critical to treat any of these conditions if present. Also, there is a strong connection between malnutrition and chronic inflammation in people with kidney disease. Eating problems may occur frequently in kidney disease patients. Protein is especially critical. If you eat too much protein, your kidneys are going to be damaged by it. If you don't eat enough, you risk malnutrition and consequent problems. Now, I'll show you what the most effective steps to tackle inflammation are. So, to lower inflammation, first step is avoid inflammatory foods. This step is vital. You cannot stop inflammation if you eat foods that cause inflammation, such as processed meats and deep fries and high fat foods. These contain both high quantities of saturated fats and trans fats. Several studies have shown that saturated fats trigger inflammation to the fat tissue. Pizza and cheese are the biggest sources of saturated fats in the average diet, but also red and processed meats and pasta dishes. Also, avoid fast foods and other fried products, processed snacks foods, frozen breakfast products, cookies, donuts, you get the idea. Also, these foods are too rich in omega-6 fatty acids. Excess consumption of omega-6 fatty acids can trigger the body to produce pro-inflammatory chemicals and negates the healthy effects of omega-3s. The body needs a healthy balance of omega-6 and omega-3 fatty acids. But while many people are lacking enough omega-3s in the diet, omega-6 are everywhere, especially in junk foods. Also, avoid refined sugar. Refined sugar is known to cause several health problems, including increased risk of obesity, diabetes, and heart disease. Now, the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition also warns that processed sugars trigger the release of inflammatory messengers called cytokines, known to cause inflammation in the body. Also, refined carbohydrates, very unhealthy and inflammatory if eaten in large amounts, and also dangerous for people with diabetes. Okay, everyone knows that the food in this list are unhealthy, but there are also hidden dangers. For example, MSG, monosodium glutamate, or MSG, is a flavor enhancing food additive most commonly found in prepared Asian food and soy sauce, but it can also be added to fast foods, prepared soups and soup mixes, salad dressings and deli meats. This chemical can trigger two important pathways of chronic inflammation and affect liver and kidney health: gluten and casein. People who have joint pain and are sensitive to gluten found in wheat, barley and rye, or casein found in dairy products, may find relief by avoiding them. And aspartame, the artificial sweetener. Your body cannot process artificial ingredients well, so substances such as aspartame and monosodium glutamate may trigger an immune response. The body frequently attacks these artificial ingredients, therefore causing inflammation. Also consider that inflammation can occur in response to other unwanted substances in the body, such as toxins from cigarette smoke or an excess of fat cells, especially fat in the belly area. Especially dangerous for CKD patients, since impaired kidneys cannot remove toxins as they should. Now, in people with CKD, inflammation prevention and treatment begins with a healthy, kidney-friendly diet. So, let's see what foods are best to reduce the inflammation. First of all, focus on foods rich in antioxidants. Vegetables such as spinach, kale, broccoli, cauliflower, and many others are very rich in antioxidants, great to fight inflammation, and are jam-packed with vitamins and phytochemicals that will help your kidney health in a multitude of ways. Unfortunately, not all greens are suitable for a renal diet. Some are too rich in potassium. My advice here is to choose those that are lower in this mineral. Cauliflower is a great option for people with CKD, but also cabbage, lettuce, celery, cucumber, and kale. Healthy fats are very important too. Extra virgin olive oil, almonds and other nuts, but also fish. These foods must always be present in your diet. Fruits. There are many fruits that are very rich in antioxidants and that can fight inflammation. Like for veggies, focus on those with lower potassium content. Apples, berries, grapes, plums, but also pears, peaches, pineapples can all be part of a healthy renal diet. Healthy foods in your diet are really important. This is why I make regular videos to show you what to eat and what to avoid. There is a playlist up here you can consider watching to know more. But while many healthy foods are rich in antioxidants, there is a special food group here that's worth mentioning. I'm talking about fatty fish. They are rich in omega-3 fatty acids that have a powerful anti-inflammatory effect. Eating fish 2 or 3 times a week helps treat inflammation because of the anti-inflammatory effect of omega-3s. But while fish oil supplements may also be used to increase omega-3s, these fishes are also rich in high-quality protein. This makes fatty fish twice as healthy because high quality protein can also fight malnutrition. As I was showing you earlier, malnutrition is a known cause of inflammation in people with CKD and is usually caused by lack of essential amino acids, the building block of protein. This is why fishes such as salmon, herring, mackerel, sardines should be your preferred source of protein. In general, it's best to get your anti-inflammatory nutrients from whole foods. However, in the case of excessive or chronic inflammation, supplements can often help bring things back into balance. Here are the home remedies that can help you fighting inflammation. First of all, baking soda. Baking soda is almost a miracle if you have kidney disease. Baking soda has incredible benefits. It can make your body more alkaline, can lower your serum potassium levels, and can even help patients slowing down the progression of chronic kidney disease. And according to a recent study in the Journal of Immunology, drinking a tonic of baking soda and water may help reduce inflammation. Also, according to the researchers, the results may be already visible after just 2 to 4 weeks. Test subjects of this study were administered 1/4 teaspoons of baking soda with 8 to 12 ounces of water. Baking soda is considered safe, but if you want to use any supplement, first check with your doctor to see if it's compatible with your health conditions and the medications you may be taking. Another home remedy that can help fighting the inflammation is turmeric. Turmeric can be one of your best allies in fighting kidney disease for several reasons. Its most effective compound, curcumin, has many scientifically proven health benefits that can help you. And most importantly, it's one of the most powerful anti-inflammatory substances you can find. The curcumin in turmeric blunts the effects of the inflammatory molecules and enzymes that cause chronic diseases. As a result, taking curcumin regularly can even lower high blood pressure and reducing kidney damage. Now, if you want to start taking turmeric, the safest route is finding a curcumin supplement. Curcumin is poorly absorbed by the body, so supplements are also going to contain a substance to improve curcumin absorption. Most commonly piperine or black powdered extract, but also essential oil or soy lecithin. Recommended dosage is 500 mg of curcumin 3 times a day if the supplement comes with piperine, and 500 mg 2 times a day if with essential oil or soy lecithin. Turmeric is considered safe in the recommended dosages and it's usually taken together with food. People that should be careful with turmeric are those suffering from kidney stones, those on anti-clotting medications, and pregnant women. So again, always consult your doctor before starting to take any supplement or home remedy. Now, another supplement that can help you is Resveratrol. Resveratrol is an antioxidant found in grapes, blueberries, and other fruits with purple skin, but also in red wine. Actually, resveratrol is what gives red wine and berries many of their health benefits. According to multiple studies, resveratrol from supplements or from foods may reduce inflammation in individuals with heart disease, insulin resistance, kidney disease, and other conditions. In a very interesting study, resveratrol supplements lowered inflammatory markers, triglycerides, and blood sugar in people with obesity. The effects observed were so evident that researchers compared them to what they would have got with calorie restriction. Yes, this is a powerful supplement. And taking it as a supplement is a way more powerful than drinking red wine. Red wine contains less than 30 mg of resveratrol per liter, or 34 odds. But most studies investigating the health benefits of resveratrol used 150 mg or more per day. And trust me, you don't want to drink 10 liters of wine per day to get the resveratrol you need. Actually, many supplements even come in dosages of 1000 or 1200 mg. But 500 mg a day is a more reasonable choice, according to research. Remember that you need the approval of your doctor to use resveratrol if you take blood thinning medications. And be smart when it comes to supplements. If you want to try any of these supplements, always buy them from a reputable manufacturer. And even more important, never start taking two or more supplements at once. Start with one and see what happens, and inform your doctor. Okay guys, a new video is coming next Friday as usual. If you don't want to miss it, subscribe and set the notification bell to all. In the meantime, keep taking good care of your kidneys and be good to yourself. This is all for today. Thank you for watching.